All right, guys, no filler, no fluff today. We're just going to get straight into it. Raycast is an app launcher for macOS. It's an awesome app launcher. I've made several videos about it before. I'll put those in the description so you can check out just more info on how the app works overall. We're not going to get into the details of that today. Today, we're going to focus on their pro subscription they just launched. It's either $10 a month or $96 per year, however you prefer to pay. And yeah, we're going to take a look at what they've added. I'll show you how they work kind of in real life compared to how it works on the marketing site. I know people like to see kind of a real person using it, and I'm a real person. I'm not sponsored by Raycast or anything. This video actually cost me nearly $100. So yeah, I hope the AdSense comes through on it. But wanted to show you the features today so you can get an idea for what is there and whether it's going to be worth it for you or not. I will also say before we jump into the screen share that as far as I can tell, and you can correct me in the comments, they did not remove anything from the app and put it behind the pro subscription. So if you were using Raycast yesterday for the past few months, past few years, and you enjoyed it, I don't think they took anything away. I think all the new pro features are new and additive to the app. So you can pay for them if you want them. And if you don't want them, you can just keep using the app how you have always used it. Will future updates prioritize people on the pro subscription versus the free features? Probably, but I don't know for sure. So we'll see how that goes. But as of today, if you've been enjoying Raycast, you can keep doing what you've always done with it. You haven't lost anything. But here's some new features that are in it, and you can decide for yourself if it's worth it to you.
Okay, so here we are on my computer. I'm going to show you the new features. This is the blog post. I'll put a link in the description where they announce it. But basically, they're walking through the big features. Raycast AI is the big kind of tentpole feature. There's some stuff there. I've made a video about that, but I'll go through the basics here. Cloud sync of your stuff between devices, custom themes, unlimited clipboard history, pro APIs. Again, you can read the post. But let's just bring up Raycast and, yeah, Raycast AI. So this is built on ChatGPT, the OpenAI GPT API. And basically, you can just hit tab and ask the AI anything. So let's say, what are the best 5 cities to live in if I love art, right? And so it's going to list, okay, there's 5 cities that it recommends. And you can actually just use that. You can do some actions to like copy the response, paste it into the app you have open, that sort of thing. Or you can hit Command J to continue in chat. And so this is kind of the full ChatGPT experience where you can kind of continue and ask follow-up questions. So that's a great list, but how about I don't want to leave the US. So how about only cities, cities in the US. So that should give me 5 cities that are good for art in the United States. There you go. And again, you can keep working on this and you can just copy this, do whatever you want. And at any point you can hit Command N to start a new chat and kind of just keep going from there. So that's pretty rad. There's also the ability to, if we switch over to the Stack Overflow page, you can also select text on your computer, on your screen, and have Raycast do things to it. So let's select this code sample that someone gave where they kind of vaguely describe but don't really explain line by line what's happening. I'm not gonna copy it or anything. I'm just going to open Raycast and I'm going to type explain code step by step. And so what this should do is go through the selected text and explain the code line by line. And that's what it's doing here, which again, for someone who kind of knows how to code but isn't an expert and like often finds Stack Overflow answers to kind of assume you're more of an expert than you are, this is a really helpful feature, but you can do this for anything. Let's go over to Raycast's own post. And I think they have a paragraph down here about why a monthly subscription. So let's just select all this and open up Raycast. And you can actually do search AI commands and they have a whole bunch built in. So let's say, explain this in simple terms. And so it's going to explain this in a little simpler terms. Cool. Whatever, not a big deal. Fix spelling and grammar. I don't know if there's any spelling and grammar issues in there, but it'll do that for you. So there's a whole bunch of things you can do to the text there. Again, made a whole other video about how this works. It's basically the same since then, so you can check that out. And I should say before we move on, actually, this is using GPT 3.5 if you're curious. According to a post in their Slack channel, they are looking at GPT-4 as an integration for pro users, but it's probably going to increase the cost of your pro subscription. So yeah, we'll see about that, but it's 3.5 right now. And honestly, it's probably fine for all the text-based stuff you do. So let's move on to the next thing, which is why does this look different than normal, right? If I like do a search here, you can see this kind of like this blue to pink gradient. How are we doing that? Well, if we type in theme, we can show the theme studio. And now Raycast has themes you can set up. So Raycast Lite is kind of the default. That's what you're used to. But they also have Raycast Dark. There's Sky. There's Sunset. There's Midnight. Dawn. I think Dawn looks really nice. Overcast is really nice. Noon is really, like, those are all great. And then ABC is my custom one that I created. So you can just create a new one at any point. Or you can go in and edit your custom theme here. And so basically there's some preset backgrounds you can do. I've done a custom one with a custom couple colors. If we change this to like more of a purple, I mean, that's a pretty good look too. You can kind of tweak it to your liking. You can change the text color, the selection color. Let's make the selection more purplish. There you go. Actually, I kind of like the faded blue. So we'll stick with that. The loader, which is going to be this thing when it's doing a search, which you don't really see very often, but there you go. And then the colors for like tags and stuff, you can customize those. I've just kind of left them as is because I almost never see them anyway. So yeah, you can go ahead and do that. Hit save, and then you can just use it. So if we switched over to like Midnight, let's set this, get out of here. And when I bring it up, we get the new Midnight theme. So yeah, really cool that you can do this. It's not incredibly powerful. It would be nice to see a little bit more customization potentially down the road, but it's a great start and lets you kind of just add a little color, if you will, to Raycast. Now for the rest, let's go into the settings. So one that is here that isn't necessarily something you should turn on, I think. I don't use clipboard history for Raycast. I use PasteBot for that. But if you use Raycast as your clipboard manager, if that's enabled for you, you've always had the ability to keep your stuff for 24 hours, 7 days, or longer terms, I think up to 3 months. Now, if you're a pro subscriber, you can save your clipboard history for 6 months, a year, or unlimited. I would be very cautious with this because every time you copy like an image, that's going to save your clipboard history and it's going to take up a lot of space. And I think even here, yeah, this is going to take up a ton of space on your hard drive. So just be careful. Yeah, do whatever you want here. But if you do have instances where you're like, didn't I copy something 8 months ago? What is that? You can actually now access that really old stuff in your Raycast clipboard history if you really want to. The other thing that's really cool is Cloud Sync. So I use Raycast on my personal computer, which we're looking at here, and my work computer, which I use at work. And I have Raycast on both those devices, but I've always had to kind of keep them in sync and like remember what extensions I have set up, like all the stuff that I've configured on one device, I have to remember to keep it the same on the other one. Otherwise, I get confused with like muscle memory not working how I think. So Cloud Sync, you can enable. It's off by default, so you have to go in to enable it. But once you enable it, all these things will sync between your devices. Of note, your clipboard history will not, again, potentially because that could be very large. Also, they've cited privacy concerns with syncing all your clipboard information. They don't necessarily want to deal with that sort of sensitive potentially information. Your passwords and credentials don't sync, and your general and advanced settings don't sync either. So, where's advanced? So yeah, these guys don't sync. I don't know why exactly, but yeah, those don't sync right now. We don't synchronize general and advanced settings. Sure, of course, that's what this means, definitely. Cloud Sync, if you use it on multiple devices, you can keep them more in sync than before. So that's cool. And then the last thing I can't really show you, but developers have access to, and I can show it here. Basically, there's pro APIs. So developers who build extensions for Raycast will have new abilities to tap into the Raycast AI features. We'll see what interesting apps or extensions come out of that. But hopefully something cool and something relatively soon. It's a vibrant community, so hopefully there will be people working on this. I'm not quite sharp enough to be able to do that, but hopefully there will be people out there doing the good work to help all of us out. So yeah, that is it for Raycast Pro. Again, you can check it out. Links in the description to find more of my videos about it. Link to Raycast website so you can check out the app. And again, there's a totally free version if you want to use that. And if you want the pro features that we showed today, you can go ahead and sign up for Raycast Pro. And that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.